Hey guys, Andrew here, and today we're going to be playing some Fallout 4. Oh, goody goody. Let's see what this has in store for us. Shouldn't be the same as the other ones, right? No apocalypse or anything like that, right? Oh, maybe.
War. War never changes. In the year 1945, my great-great-grandfather, serving in the army, wondered when he'd get to go home to his wife and the son he'd never seen. He got his wish when the U.S. ended World War II by dropping atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. The world awaited Armageddon. Instead, something miraculous happened. We began to use atomic energy not as a weapon, but as a nearly limitless source of power. People enjoyed luxuries once thought the realm of science fiction. Domestic robots, fusion-powered cars, portable computers. But then, in the 21st century, people awoke from the American dream. Years of consumption led to shortages of every major resource. The entire world unraveled. Peace became a distant memory. It is now the year 2077. We stand on the brink of total war. And I am afraid. For myself. For my wife. For my infant son. Because if my time in the army taught me one thing, it's that war. War never changes. War never changes.
You're gonna knock him dead at the Veterans Hall tonight, hon.
You think?
Absolutely. Now get ready and stop hogging the mirror.
Right.
Well, what a delightful woman this is. Thanks for that, rude-ass bitch. Alright, anyways, looks like we're gonna do character design again. Huh. Alright, this one's a little bit more intricate than Fallout 3, from what I can remember. So, I'm gonna go ahead and speed up time, because there's no reason for you to sit here and watch me actually do all this in slow motion. So, yeah, see you guys then. Okay, and let's see, now we're here. Okay, sorry I didn't get a chance to show you what exactly I look like on the screen. What ended up happening was the game crashed because, I don't know, day one, launch, crashes, frequent. So, we're kind of in that kind of position. So, whoa, what's going on over here? A lot of stuff.
Another fine product of General Atomics International.
Okay, well, General Atomics International sounds like somebody who probably took good advantage of the atomic age and decided to buy good stuff, or create good stuff for people to buy. Be the better word for it. I have a child? Oh my god, that thing is hideous. It's just like, you're special, hey, that book.
Grow up to be.
I remember that book. I used to have that in Fallout 3 when I was a baby. And it was right, I was special.
Ah, broken again. We really need to get those vacation photos developed.
Vacation photos from that thing? Ha ha ha. Don't make me laugh. Oh! Hello, Godfried. Codsworth? Never mind, you're a different robot. Wait, we have a Vault-Tec calendar? Great.
Grognak the Barbarian and the Jungle of the Bat Babies. My favorite.
Oh, Grognak comics, just like in Fallout 3. Ooh, cigarettes.
Now, who left those here?
I did, probably, because I want cigarettes.
Hmm.
No.
More of the same.
Okay. Or not.
Codsworth.
Enjoy your coffee, sir.
Oh, where's my... Oh. Is there actually coffee in there? Oh, there is. There's just like a weird tint on the light. Huh. Oh. Here. What?
You know,
what? Wait, what? Okay, she just teleported here, right? She just teleported here. She did not casually walk over here. She teleported here. Holotape player?
Bunch of our old holotape recordings.
What? What? There's a Vault-Tec guy driving around. What you doing there, Vault-Tec guy? Uh-oh. So you coming to my house? Oh, shit. Honey, answer the door.
Hun?
Nervous? Don't be. Everyone's gonna love the speech.
What? What speech? What are we talking about? There's a guy at the door.
Can you get that? It's probably that salesman. He comes for you every day.
Fine, I'll answer it.
Good morning. Vault-Tec calling.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Isn't it? Just look at that sky out there. You can't begin to know how happy I am to finally speak with you. I've been trying for days. It's a matter of utmost urgency, I assure you.
Urgency? Okay, well, glad you're here then.
Then I'm glad you caught up with me.
Oh, me too. You have no idea. Now, I know you're a busy fellow, so I won't take up much of your time. Time being a precious commodity. I'm here today to tell you that because of your family service to our country, you have been pre-selected for entrance into the local vault. Vault 111.
Okay. Sounds great.
Sounds great.
Oh, it is. Believe you me. Now, you're already cleared for entrance in the unforeseen event of total atomic annihilation. I just need to verify some information. That's all.
Okay. Sure.
Sure. Let's do it.
Splendid. Splendid. Now, let's see.
Oh, okay, so this is the whole starting thing. Okay, well, name is gonna be that. There we go. All right, strength. What do I want to put my stuff into? That's a good question. I probably want to, I get 21, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Charisma, agility, luck, 2, agility, 3, charisma, 3, endurance, 5. Okay, that should be perfect. Now, I'm not going on based on any kind of guide or anything, if you're wondering why I specifically made numbers certain things. I do know for a fact that 5 is usually the standard quo when trying to pick certain skill sets, so... If you're trying to be, like, say, a hacker or a thief or stuff like that, 5 is usually the one you want to go into. So I put 5 into strength, perception, endurance, and intelligence because those are the 4 stats that tend to have really cool stuff associated with them. Endurance or charisma, agility, and luck are usually things that I don't really care about because I'm not going to try to talk my way out of bad situations. I'll just kill everybody. And I don't really need much agility. It's mostly just running. Strength is what allows you to carry stuff, so that's all I care about. And luck is usually just, it's luck. I don't give a crap about that. So.
Wonderful. That's everything. Just gonna walk this over to the vault. Congratulations on being prepared for the future.
Thanks again.
Hey, it's peace of mind. That's worth a little paperwork, right?
For you and Sean, no price is too high.
Good answer.
I have my moments.
I thought we had a robot for this.
Sean has been changed, but he absolutely refuses to calm down. I think he needs some of that paternal affection you seem to be so good at.
Okay.
You heard Codsworth. Go on.
Well, I'll give it some paternal affection. Ugh, God, this thing's so ugly.
Most important man in my life doing? Spin the mobile a bit. He loves that.
Okay. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Calm down there, rocket chips. Let's not fly away to the moon already.
How's my little guy? Much better now, huh? Listen, after breakfast, I was thinking we could head to the park for a bit. Weather should hold up.
Oh, you can just move. Whoa, 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 game! go to the park, and do what?
And do what exactly?
Sir, Mom, you should come and see this.
Codsworth, what's wrong?
Well, he never gets antsy like that. What's up, Codsworth?
Followed by flashes, blinding flashes, sounds of explosions. We're trying to get confirmation.
What?
We seem to have lost contact with our affiliate stations.
Hey, Codsworth.
We do have coming in.
Listen.
That's confirmed reports. I repeat, confirmed reports of nuclear detonations in New York and Pennsylvania. My God.
Oh my God.
We
don't drop the kid. Jesus Christ! What was wrong with that? Oh God. All right, so we need to go, 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 go. Nice vault car. Can I take this thing? No, I can't take this thing. Okay, well, let's take my car. I've got a plenty good car. Let's go in the car. Nope, can't take the cars. Okay, well, I guess we're gonna be running now. Run, 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 run. Are you running down the street with a child? What the fuck is wrong with you? This game's kind of wonking out a little bit here and there. I'm dropping frames pretty quickly. What's going on? I'm not too sure about that. In any case, everybody seems to be panicking. I guess I would be panicking too if a nuclear weapon just went off in like some other place. He said he's gonna walk it over to the vault. Is the vault literally within walking distance? Oh my God, it is. It's like right here. What the hell? That's amazing. I can't believe.
You can't stop.
Hey.
Okay.
We need to get in. We're on the list.
Infant.
We're not in the
adult male.
Program.
Adult female.
God, we're gonna die.
Okay, go
Don't
ahead.
Great.
You.
Get to the vault.
Good luck, man.
You two, follow me.
Oh, yeah. Well then, you were on your feet there, sir, aren't you? You just immediately turned around and hightailed it. All right, come on. Let's all go. We're having a good time. We're all having a good time. What the hell is this? Are you serious? The vault door is an elevator? Are you out of your fucking mind? Why didn't they have Fallout 3 vaults? Those ones were way better and smarter designed.
I love you. Both of you.
We love you too.
Oh my God!
Put us in the vault! Put us in the vault! Put us in the goddamn vault right now!
Oh God.
So much radiation just hit my body right now. Wow, they really just were relentless with those nukes. They were just launching them off all over the place. Hey, you get one, you get one, and you get one. Everybody gets a nuke. We all have enough nukes for everybody. That was really weird. I don't know why you would think you would survive that. I feel like if a nuclear bomb did go off, you would not be able to survive the wave. Like the shockwave would be crazy. Like you would just die from the shockwave itself.
Please step off the elevator and proceed up the stairs in an orderly fashion.
Holy shit, wait a second. How long is this elevator?
Get everyone situated in your new home. Vault 111.
Okay.
Better future. Underground.
A better future under. There's two doors? There's an elevator and a door? Oh my God, this is security. This is security of Fallout 3 vaults didn't have for some reason. Why is that? Is this a different future? Wait, what's going on?
Over to the table, okay. Take a suit. This way.
Welcome. Pick up a suit right over there. Just step over.
What? Oh.
This way, please.
Thanks. What now?
Just follow the doctor here. He'll show
Just
you where
way.
To go.
All right, you three. Follow me.
Okay.
It's down the hallway. Right
oh, okay, here we go. I was like, hey, doc, where are we going?
This is one of our most advanced facilities. Not that the others aren't great, mind you. It's gone. Our home.
Wait, so this, like, Vault 111 is apparently the most advanced vault in the entire vault system?
How long do you think we'll be down here? I know this
is a difficult time. Oh, we'll be going over all that in orientation. Just a few medical items we have to get through first.
Checking everyone off the list as they come in.
Oh my God, are we doing cryo sleep?
right?
Such a lovely.
No way. No way. You do cryo sleep? What? What? That's how.
And put your vault suit on.
Oh. Oh wait. Oh. Oh whoa! I can like view myself. That's kind of cool. I look awesome. Well, first I'm gonna save real quick, cause that was crazy. I'll write that. I guess I'll just activate it. Oh, my suit's on now. Okay, cool. I don't know how that happened.
The pod will decontaminate and depressurize you before we head deeper.
What about the baby?
Just relax.
Wait, is it okay to have a child in there?
For a whole new life.
Resident secure.
Okay.
Occupant vitals normal.
Okay.
Procedure complete.
Oh, that wasn't bad at all.
5, 4, 3.
Wait, what just happened? I freeze? Okay, so they like specifically put us into cryo sleep. That's awful, by the way. That's terrible that they would just freeze you and not tell you they were freezing you. So now we're gonna wake up like super far in the fucking future and we're not gonna have any idea what just happened. We're gonna be like, wait, how long in the future? Wait, what year is it? How did we get here? What the hell? Who are these people now? Like, is the world habitable? What happened to the world? Everything's gonna be crazy. Oh, I can wake up now. Oh. Whoa, hey. What you guys doing over here? That guy's got a gun. Not okay with that. Not okay with guns. How do I get out of here? Is there like a way out of this fucking... Oh, awake. I feel like it should... Okay, can't get out of here. I feel like if it's open, or if I'm awake, I should be able to get out, because that means like the cryo freeze, or the cryo sleep thing has faded away, or did they just turn it off for everybody? Are they just trying to steal the baby? Whoa, we could sort this out. We could sort this out. Trust me, we can do. Oh, it's gonna be one of those kind of games. Okay. Oh, it's gonna be like one of those kind of games. Ooh, putting me back to sleep again, huh? I guess I'm gonna wait until I wake up and then my kid will be an adult or some bullshit and that'll be the whole story. I don't care, man. I'm gonna kill that bald guy. I'm gonna kill him straight up, super quick. Walk out of this vault, take a baseball bat, bash him in the face with it. Fact, I will tell you that right now. I don't care what happens, I will bash him with a baseball bat. That would be the first prerogative. I'm calling it. Gonna kill the final boss with a baseball bat. Okay. Oh god, do I have like atrophy from not walking forever?
Come on! There has to be a release! Come on! Oh god!
I'll find who did this. And I'll get Sean back.
I can't open anybody else.
Why would Vault-Tec do this?
Malfunction in cryopod manual release override.
What's going on? Tell me about this, Terminal. Alright, thank you for choosing Vault-Tec. Cryogenic array offline. Premature termination. Result in system failure. Isolated manual and remote overrides detected. Controls disabled. Oops, did not mean to do that. Life support. Life support offline. Premature termination. Resulting in system failure. Isolated manual. Okay. Pod occupation stats. Pod 1, empty. Miss Callan, Mr. Callan, Abel, Miss Abel, Nora and Sean, infant. What? Occupant status unknown. Pod door manual override engaged. Me. Wait. What? Wait a second. What? Me, just Knackle. And then Mr. Russell? Where's... Oh, Nora and Sean, infant. Okay. Okay, that's my wife and stuff. That's weird. They're the only ones that get... We're the only ones that get first names. Huh. That's really weird. Wonder why we get first names. Everybody else doesn't. Okay. Well, I guess let's just open the door and see what's going on. Oh, more life support systems? Holy shit. Wow, these people are all just... Wow, this whole thing's just a cryo sleep station. Vault 111 is just a cryo station? A cryo sleep station?
Can't be the only one left.
Hello?
Did none of these people make it? Cause of death. Asphyxiation due to life support failure. What? Asphyxiation due to life support failure. They all died by life support failure? Oh, God. This is awful. What the hell's going on? How did all these people die in cryosleep? How did the life support system fail? I thought it's a vault. How do you open the vault when you're not in the vault? You can't just... Wait, rad roaches? How are the rad roaches? How did rad roaches get in here? Safety first. Okay, well, I'll take the stent back. That's safety. I'll take the cigarettes. Shit. Is there anything else? Pre-war money? I'll take the pre-war money. Okay. Great. Oh, wait. Oh, that's a sliding door. Open the door. I don't even know if I'm going the right way, by the way. I'm just going, like, to the core. I'm following the symbol, the little symbol. I'm going to the core. Security baton. Done. Equipped it. Press R. Oh, shit. Fuck off. Don't you dare touch me again. Give me that rad roach meat.
Roaches? What the hell?
Beer bottles? Are they opened? No, they're making the sound like they're not opened, so I'll take it. Wait, how do I check my inventory? Great, same kitchen layout that I had at my house. That's great. Hot plate? Okay. Toaster? No, I don't need a toaster. What's in the toilet? A bunch of shit. Okay. Wow. Straight like 100-something years and it rusts all over. Well, that's pretty normal. It's pretty normal. Wow, everything's been vacated. Like someone came through and just ransacked this place for materials. Alright, well, let's keep going in, I guess. Let's just keep seeing. Whoa. Okay, so that place will shock you if you're on the ground, so we need to be extra careful about that. Excuse you, taking rad roach meat. Oh, Jesus. Excuse you, taking rad roach meat. There's a dead vault patron, I guess.
Where is everyone?
I don't think the skeleton's gonna answer that question for you, sir. What? Stop it. Ow! Fuck. Stop it. Bunch of assholes. Alright, I guess let's go inside. Oh, I should probably heal up. I don't know if I'm drinking it or not. It's not really doing. Oh, there's a dead scientist.
Is this all that's left?
Oh god, that's a lot of stem packs. Fuck yeah. I'll take the pistol, take the bullets, I'll take the glasses, because I need glasses. Actually, I do need glasses, because that would be more like Overseer's terminal, is that what it just said? Overseer! Oh my god. Confidential. Overseer eyes only. Vault 111 is designed to test the long-term effects of suspended animation on unaware human subjects. Your staff will be on short-term assignment to monitor basic cardiopulmonary and cognitive functions. Long-term monitoring will be handled remotely by Vault Tech technicians. Under no circumstances is suspension to be disrupted. This includes the administration of life-saving measures. Your staff is also considered expendable. Insubordination or attempts to evacuate prematurely are capital violations. Unused cryogenic pods are the preferred method for cadaver disposal. Alright. I've long dreamed of making cryogenic freezing available to in a portable on-demand form. The cryolator is my latest attempt. Thankfully, we are in no short supply of the chemicals and components I need to tinker with the prototype. It's a nice way to occupy the time as we wait for the all-clear signal. Operations Protocol Manager. Residential. Upon activation notice from Vault Tech, all personnel are required to report to the entry area and assist with the admittance of Vault residents. Security personnel will maintain order and ensure that no personnel or residents attempt to evacuate the vault. Research staff will be responsible for resident intake and escort each to the designated cryogenic pod. Residents not accounted for in the manifest should be asked to step aside and detained forcefully by security if necessary. Once all residents have been sealed into their preservation chambers, dispose of any detainees. Vault entryway must remain sealed under any circumstances. Huh. Staff duties. Okay, this is pretty, this is a lot of lore. Overseer's log. Let's get to know what's going down here. Preparations. The final staff orientation is complete, but all but a few of the residents down in Sanctuary Hills have been enrolled, and several from Concord as well. Vault-Tec supervisors came up this week to do a technical review with me. This vault is ready to open. I can only imagine what wonders our residents will get to witness. The notion of leaping forward in time. I almost wish I could join them and see the promise of our future realized. Okay, October 23rd. It's happened. We were lucky that most of the staff was nearby when the early warning came through. We had less notice than expected, but only Nordhagen was missing when we sealed the entrance. Resident admittance went smoothly. Everyone made it, and even the family that waited until the last minute. I was worried there would be more suspicion, but things happened so fast for these people, they must have been too overwhelmed to question the cryogenic pods. Uh-oh. Strange issue today with Pod C3. Subject appeared to be having heart palpitations. Nothing life-threatening, but unusual. We realized almost too late that the pod was malfunctioning. The cryogenic array almost started thawing her out. We're not sure, but I suspect a hiccup in Vault-Tec's remote override systems may have sent an errant signal. We'll have to keep an eye out. I only hope their systems are reliable once we evacuate the staff. There's been no all-clear signal yet, even though we're nearing the end of the 180-day mandatory shelter period. Supplies were never intended to last much more than that, and despite my best efforts, people are beginning to question what we're doing down here. If people think we can just leave when the 108 days are up, they're insane. The radioactive exposure still would be potent enough to fry everyone if the vault seals are breached that early. The whole point of the all-clear was to receive additional instructions from the main office. I don't know what to do. I can't open the vault. I can't expect our supplies to last forever. I just have to keep everything under control until the all-clear. Faction led by the security personnel have turned on me, demanding they be allowed to leave the vault. Idiots. I will not open the door to be irradiated to death out there. I'm consolidating the remaining supplies, putting the staff on lockdown. We're going to have to start prioritizing who deserves what little food we have left. I've been too goddamn generous with the rations. If people don't like it, well, that's fewer mouths to feed. Okay, well, I kind of get an idea. Oh, wait. I should check one last thing. Open evacuation tunnel. Personnel evacuation tunnel is now open. Remind all staff to be orderly and follow shutdown protocols before exiting and resealing Vault 111. Please maintain all staff records and research report to your local Vault-Tec supervisors for debriefing and further instructions. Alright, well, that's all I needed. Okay, time to go around and check this stuff. Got nothing in here, got nothing in here. Let's see, a bunch of empty boxes, a sink, a door, a toilet, and what's in here? Millimeter rounds, can take that. Cigarettes, taking that. Let's see.
Nice. Coming back later for you.
No bobby pins? No bobby pins? No fucking bobby pins! I got a pencil. Oh, somebody needs to have a bobby pin. Yo, man, I can't be doing this. You can't do this to me, man. That's awesome looking. The cryolator. That looks so cool!
If I only had a bobby pin.
Ugh. Who needs bobby pins anyways? Oh, ooh, there we go. Ha 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 ha. Ooh, yes.
Won't be able to pick this.
What? What? I just got my bobby pin. Oh, God, why? Why? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Can we, no. No. How do I check the... Oh, shit! Oh, God. Ah, God damn it. No, come on, I don't want to waste my fucking... I didn't want to waste all my pistol ammo on this. I just want to fucking... What the fuck? Hey! I want to go back to the baton. It's really dumb that it automatically put me into my fucking... into the gun, and I don't want to use the gun, because it's... Oh, whoa, whoa, wait, what's this? There's a quick change option? Oh, shit. I wanted to... Oh, I don't remember reading anything about that. Did that pop up? Tell me in the comments if that popped up. I have no idea if that popped up. I don't think it did. I think I would have noticed that if it told me, like, you could change weapons by pressing the D-pad. I think it would have been like, oh, hey, that's pretty handy. But it didn't, so... Whoa! That body's a little... Oh, never mind. It's scalp.
anyone get out?
I'm assuming nobody got it. Oh, perform melee attacks using RB. Yeah, no. Not gonna use a melee attack with a gun. Pip-Boy, though. I'll take that. Okay. That guy's hand just fell out. Hey, could you give me a hand? This is actually a really nice looking Pip-Boy. Okay. Oh, cool. Okay, so my Pip-Boy's working now. Okay, inventory. Oh, wow. Whoa, there's a whole bunch of favorites you can do. Holy snap, that's gonna be awesome. Now it's telling me all this stuff you can do with the Pip-Boy way too quickly. Yeah, so obviously it's my favorite pistol because I only have one apparel. I need eyeglasses on wedding ring. I could wear both my wedding wings. I don't care. Aid, Rad Roach Meat, miscellaneous. How is it doing a 3D model of Rad Roach Meat? Someone actually put that in there? Like, weren't these invented before Fallout happened? How do they know what Rad Roach Meat is? Sci-fi stuff. All right, beer bottle. What can beer bottles do? I think this is, like, wasteful. I can't drink them, so I don't need them. Pencils, I think, are also worthless to me. These are good, though. Cigarettes are useful. Preserved cigarette pack is useful. Mods, ammo, okay. Out of time. Thank you for knowing that. The time is currently 9:01 a.m. Really? Whoa, this map, though. Oh, Jesus. Well, I guess when you're Bethesda, you're like, ha, I could just make the biggest map possible. It's like, yeah, I guess good. Wow, that's all the way at the end. Oh, perk chart. Oh, okay. So... ah, see? Ooh, look at that. So there's a... so it shows you what you... okay. So yeah, it shows you what you put your basic stuff into. So 5 stars, you could put however many... it shows how many stars you put in depending on what it is. Okay, cool. Well, that's good to know. All right. Oh, geez, 3 bottles just... in a line. That was amazing. Oh, that was great. Okay, anywhom, let's go ahead and check around here. Is it like a rotoscope? Is it like a way to check what's going on out there in the future? I don't know. Open it up. Whoa, what? What the hell just happened? Is there gonna be more stuff that has that, or is that just like a one-time thing? I'm glad this, like, device still works after all this time. Actually, before that happens, I'm gonna go ahead and save the game because I don't trust that it's not gonna break on me. Oh, it just saved previously, so that's fine. Okay. Looks like we're opening the vault here. Ooh, ooh. The nostalgic feels from Fallout 3. Getting the all clear. Oh, it's gonna walk along those gates, isn't it? Oh, beautiful. Oh, so bright. So bright. So beautiful. Yo, how do I, oh. That just falls down and breaks. Oh, time to leave. I have a dead wife, missing child, and it's my first time stepping out into the world in 100 and some odd years. I think. Maybe it's 100 years. Maybe I'm lying. I don't know. But God, is that a slow gate. Oh, that's... wait, B is how you open the Pip-Boy? Oh, that's interesting. No, I think everything else is good. Let's go ahead and leave the vault. One less chance to change your appearance. The cryogenic sleep melted your face off. You can go ahead and make a new one if you need to. It's like, what the hell? Whoa, what is that? Is that a bot fly? The fiercest flying insect in the Commonwealth, the Stingwing, strikes relentlessly with its poison stinger. Oh, God, that thing is hideous looking. Look at the graphics on it. Look at those graphics. That's like a scorpion thing. It's like a scorpion hybrid. Scorpion fly? I don't know. Oh, wow. So much motion blur.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah. It's been a while since you breathed, breathed oxygen, huh? Wow. Whole destroyed world. This used to be my home at one point, and now it is nothing. Nothing more than just a mere wasteland. All I could see is fallout from one end of the world to the other. Welcome to the apocalypse. Alright, let's go start killing people. Woohoo! Okay, so now that we're out in the wastelands after so long, it's been so long since we've been out into the wastelands. I remember coming up this way not that long ago, running up here, running away from the threat of an apocalypse with my child and wife. Apparently, I need to learn to sprint. I don't think that's really necessary. One of these houses is mine. I just can't remember which one it was. I think it was that one. Hey, there's my robot. Did you survive?
As I live and breathe. Oh, it's really you.
Whoa, Codsworth. You're still here?
Codsworth? You're still here. So, other people could still be alive too.
But of course I'm still here. Surely you don't think a little radiation could deter the pride of General Atomics International. But you seem the worse for wear. Best not let the wife see you in that state, hmm? Where is the missus, by the way?
They killed her.
They killed her.
Sir, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes, a distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
He's been kidnapped.
Sean's been kidnapped. But I'm going to find him. I'm going to get my son back.
It's worse than I thought. Mm-hmm. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
Whoa, wait. Chill out, 200 years? 200 as in like 200?
200 years? What? Are you...
A bit over 210, actually, sir. Or give or take a little. For the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack? You must be famished.
Are you okay?
Codsworth, you're acting a little bit weird. What's wrong?
Oh, sir, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car... The car! How do you polish rust?
Whoa, stay with me.
Stay with me, pal. Focus.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, sir. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were... dead. I did find this holotape. I believe the missus was going to present it to you. As a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
Holotape? Thank you.
Thank you, Codsworth.
You're welcome. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? The missus and young Sean may turn up yet.
Sure.
All right. Lead the way.
Proud to serve, sir.
Cool. Someone put a teddy bear in a mailbox. That's okay, I guess. I don't know why you would do that, but whatever, I'll believe it.
This should be fun! I dare say I'm slightly. This should be fun!
Oh my god, Codsworth! Codsworth! Have you been fighting these things for like 200 years? Okay, so it's the same old. Haha, opened it.
Yes.
Ooh, look at all that stuff. Oh, I just made bank.
My senses are picking up movement in another house.
What?
Follow me.
Oh, what the hell is that? Weird cat-like monster? Oh, come on, Codsworth, let's go on our journey to find something. I don't know what we're looking for exactly. Are we looking for other people? Because I don't think there's going to be many other people. Oh, not more botflies. Look at all these people with Halloween decorations. What the hell time of year was it? Was it really Halloween when everybody... the nukes went off? Oh, jeez. Codsworth, are you going to come with me the whole time? Because this would be amazing. You'd take care of all the problems I don't want to deal with.
Your family isn't here either. They're really gone, aren't they?
Sean's out there.
Sean's out there, Codsworth. I need to find him.
What about Concord, sir? Plenty of people there. And last I checked, they only pummeled me with sticks a few times before I had to run back home.
Concord?
There's still people alive in Concord?
Yes, although they're a bit rough. You remember the way? Just across the southern footbridge, out of the neighborhood, and past the Red Rocket Station? I shall remain here and secure the home.
Okay, well, I mean, if you're gonna stay here and, you know, keep everything fine. You took a plastic pumpkin. I'll take that shit. Yeah, I mean, if you're gonna stay here and protect the home front, then, you know, I don't really mind. I'll go to Concord and see what's going on in that place. Sounds like it can't be too bad. Actually, I want to go ahead and go to my inventory. Want to go to miscellaneous. Play this.
Oopsie. No. Fingers away. There we go. Okay. Right there. Yay. Hi, honey. Listen, I don't think that Sean and I need to tell you how great of a father you are. But we're going to anyway. Isn't that right? You are kind and loving. And funny. That's right. And patient. So patient. Patience of a saint, my mom used to say. Look, with Sean and us all being home together, it's been an amazing year. But even so, I know our best days are yet to come. There'll be changes, sure. Things we need to adjust to. You'll rejoin the civilian workforce and I'll shake the dust off my law degree. But everything we do, no matter how hard, we do it for our family. Now, say goodbye, Sean. Bye-bye. Say bye-bye. Come on. Bye, honey. We love you.
Okay, well, that was touching in some way or another. I'm not too sure. All I know is I'm an amazing husband. That's all that matters. I'm awesome. I'm the best fucking husband ever. I'm so good to let my wife die in cryo sleep. Wait a second. It didn't sound very good. That didn't come out right. No, never mind. I'm sorry. I didn't mean that way. It was... Wait. Wow, he really did a good job keeping my house clean. Holy smackaronis.
Excellent.
Yes. Thank you. Wow, I can't believe... Whoa, wait a second. Can we put that back? Yeah, let's put that back. I didn't mean to take a bread box. wow. He really did a good job keeping my fucking house clean. What's in the fridge? Empty milk bottle. Probably because no one came to deliver milk after the apocalypse. Mr. Handy Fuel? Huh. Does he run on fuel? That's weird. Wait a second. That's not right. That room wasn't there. That room was here. Wait, right? Am I remembering this correctly? Came out of... Wait, this was the bathroom? It came out the bathroom... No, wait. Maybe that is right. I can't remember. For some reason, it's not clicking. Oh, well, whatever. I'll take the dress. Clothes are a pretty good commodity, you know. Don't need baby stuff. Your special book. Pick an attribute to improve. I didn't know that would happen, so I'm going to improve my agility. That's pretty funny, actually, that works, though.
I'm coming, buddy.
Yeah, probably not. Blast Radius board game? Hell yeah. It's in bad taste now after, you know, an apocalypse, but it's still funny nonetheless. I think it can go for a pretty penny. I think someone will laugh about it. I really don't know why there's fuel for the robot, and if he does take fuel, did he take everybody else's fuel? Like, I don't really, I'm not too sure how this works.
Codsworth.
There must be someone who can help you in Concord.
Okay, if you say so. Now I'm gonna go to Concord. First I'll probably scavenge a town a bit though, right? I mean, I should probably see what every other house has to offer. You never know, they might have some good stuff. I mean, so far I've been taking a pretty good heaping of stuff. I mean, some people seem to have had, what's it called? Some ammo and things like that. I mean, ammo's pretty handy to me. I don't know, in an apocalypse situation? Ammo's pretty handy. I'm just kind of taking what I think might be valuable, and I'll go through and look at it when I'm done. It's a bottle. Bottle's worthless to me. Only if it has a cap on it. I'm trying to go around and just take whatever I feel it looks like it might be valuable at some point. Then I'll just go through and, you know, if it's not valuable, get rid of it. And fucking damn rad roaches. If it's not valuable, then I'll just toss it out later. Take the cigar. I don't know how much... Oh, Jesus. Were you stuck in the trash can? Oh, that's amazing. That's where you belong. Oh, perfect. Oh, hell yeah. First aid pack. That's amazing. I love first aid packs. I'm so glad that they left out a bunch of, Oh, no. Oh, no. My only bobby pin.
Bobby pins.
Ah! I broke it. Wow, it actually lasts. That's pretty... It's actually pretty impressive that your bobby pins last when... they don't get used up after you use it one time. Huh. I didn't know that. That's kind of nifty. Screwdriver? No. Can I use a screwdriver? No, I don't think I could use a screwdriver. I was looking for more bobby pins. I would figure somebody's house had bobby pins. Like, of all the things I care the most about, it's like bobby pins are kind of one of the big important ones. It's like, I would like to be able to just keep taking, wow, people just came and raided everything here. Just everything's been raided. That's crazy. Can't activate television. Okay. Just wanted to test it out, but, you know, it just doesn't work. Oh, yeah, what's the thermostat? Apparently it's still the same temperature it was when I first left. So this... Oh. This is just a gun laying around? Really? This terminal still has power? How? Select a potential password with LS. Press A to enter. If your chosen password is incorrect, the number of letters that match terminal's password... Okay. Zero. That's not good. That's not good either. Does that trick still work? Can you just keep doing that? Yeah, you can. It's not oily. Onto. Ugh, I don't know. It's kind of obnoxious, actually. raid? Like this one? What? Fuck. Hire? No. Like this one? Bear? Like this two? It doesn't tell me what likeness, though. I'm assuming it's R. I'm assuming R is one of them. So, bear... R-E... No, because Hire only had a likeness of one, and Raid had a likeness of one, so R is the similarity. But bear... So A was a similarity. A-R... Is there a word with AR? Raid. I tried raid. That's a likeness of one. What? So then B? Was the B that's the same? So BR? But there's no other BRs. Is there? No. Sash. There's no other BRs. So that can't be right. I really hate these password things when you're not like... We're not a pro hacker. It's really unfortunate. Gold. Took. Whatever, that worked. Okay. Sanctuary Hills. Okay, that's weird. Load holotape.
Oopsie. No.
Check the holotape. I didn't know you could do that. You could add a holotape to the computer. That's kind of cool. Conquered. Still good for a couple of hits of Oh Daddy a week. Pretentious pseudo-intellectual asshole, but his money's good. Wants Med X as much as I can get. Hasn't told me why. Not really my business. Guessing there's some sort of long-term pain management going on. Disease. Kids are usually a no-go, but this girl's got style, and she's not interested in getting tweaked. Ordered 20 blood packs, some Halloween stunt or something. Or hell, maybe she's really a vampire. What do I care? She's got her daddy's money. Williams needs medics. That's good to know. Boston. Wow, he's got fucking shit all over the place. Totally high strung and needs to relax. I keep telling him that offering to help, but so far no dice. By the looks of the guy, he's self-medicating with pie. My favorite tinfoil hat wearing nut job. Good for 7 amples of day tripper a week. Guess he's a one a day kind of guy. Whatever helps a man groove. Still trying to get some of her buff out. Didn't expect the rationing to affect this, but it is what it is. He wants something called Psycho. I'm not sure the stuff. I'm not sure the stuff even exists. And if it does, do I really want this Neanderthal using it? Guess it depends on how much he's willing to spend. I'll put some feelers out to my army connection. See where that goes. They still owe me for that last Excel delivery occurred to me. Was it even for them? Because so help me God, if I find out they're juicing up those dogs, we're going to have words about more than money. But we're probably beyond words anyway. I know that they have a floor safe in there. I've seen it. Master bedroom under the dresser. Can't be tough crack. Okay, well that guy had like a bunch of logs on everybody. That is also a makeshift bomb. I disarmed it and took it. Did not realize it was sitting there the whole time. Oh, wow.
He'd... Out of bobby pins.
Fuck. Fucking bobby pins. That is Med-X. Good. I needed some of that. No one really has bobby pins. No one. Just nobody. Nobody in this fucking apocalypse wasteland has bobby pins. Come on, people. Like, it's not that hard. Just have a bobby pin. Oh, 3 bobby pins. There we go. Dunzo. Did not mean to do that. Meant to go here. There we go. Got it.
Sweet.
Yes, 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 yes. Thank you. Okay, where was the other thing that had the lock on it that I needed to unlock? Something else had a lock on it. I think it was this room. I think it was this house. House, do you have a lock somewhere that needs to be unlocked? I think you do. I think you had a safe or something. Oh, this needed to be unlocked. That's what it was. What you got in here?
Nice.
Bobby pin, suspenders and slacks. Perfect, suspenders and slacks. Is that any good to me? Miscellaneous, you're special. I already used that, right? I already used that, already. Okay. Can't read it, okay. Apparel. Laundered rose dress. I can inspect it. Great. That looks amazing. Okay. Clean blue suit. Value. Endurance. Charisma. Let's see. Endurance. Suspenders and slacks. Charisma or endurance? What do I want more of? I guess endurance, right? Sure. How do I look? Wow. I look like I did not step out of a vault. Looks like I've been here for a while. Oh, whoa, that's kind of nifty. Wow. That's really handy. Oh, you can just run around third person forever. Whoa, that's kind of cool. Okay, so I'm just gonna run around like this. This house looks completely destroyed. What was in that mailbox? Don't know. Yeah, this house looks completely thrashed, so I can't get in there. So that sucks. Okay, well, I guess gonna head over to Bob or wherever. Oh no, there's still more houses to explore. Let's go check these houses out first. And then we're gonna head over to Concord. Nope, that house is completely destroyed. Sound like somebody need a beating, though. Beaten, delivered. That's what you get. Don't step to me like that. Cooking station. Whoa. Delivering beatings. This cooking station actually looks new. Craft. What the fuck is this? Roast? Oh, grilled rad roach. Holy crap, are you serious? You can like cook them now? I didn't know you could cook food. This is amazing. This is like the best discovery I've ever made the whole game. Yeah. Make. Oh my god, look how much fucking stuff I just made. Vegetable starch? Beverage. Really? You can make beverages? Wow. That's awesome. By the way, modding and crafting stations and workshop locations will automatically share items you store in them, but only if you unlock the workshop in their location. Huh. Oh, so you could transfer all your supplies. Oh, you could transfer all your stuff to it, so that way the workshop... Wait, the workshop has all this? Oh, so then... Okay, so if I turn this into a base of operations, then I can use this place, and then... I can transfer stuff from the workshop. So I can transfer supplies that I need to use for a workshop, like wood and crafting materials, to it. Fishing rod? That's weird. Yeah, so I could take... Okay, I think I'm kind of getting the hang of this. I think I'm kind of understanding exactly what's going on here. Can't activate that television. Okay, that's kind of nifty. All right. These cars, man. These cars are just, like, so weird, but also so cool looking. Anyways, I think that's gonna about do it for now. Let me go ahead and check this mailbox, see if anybody sent mail. To throw grenades or replace mines, equip them in the Pip-Boy and then hold and release RB. I don't want to throw a bomb yet, but ooh, wow, that is nice looking water. This game looks a lot better than its predecessor, Fallout 3, because I tell you what, Fallout 3 does not hold up in time. I'll take this cram too. Okay, so that's a fucked up boat. All right, well, next time we're gonna play, or next time Fallout on Fallout 4, we're gonna go to Concord over there, over yonder. So, yep, that's where we're going. So yeah, thank you for watching. See you guys next time. Hopefully we will, I look like the guy off Heroes. God damn it, I look like that, the Mr. Glasses guy off Heroes, don't I? Oh man, I look like that guy. God damn it. Oh no, anyways. Next time on Fallout 4, we're going to go ahead and go over to Concord. We're going to have some fun. So thank you guys for watching. See you guys next time.